Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to your Courseplay tutorial for Farming Simulator 15. Today we're going to cover how to sell crops with Courseplay. Now I do have a Courseplay worker running somewhere around here. It's on field 30, and that's important because you can run multiple courses at once. I'm sure I showed that off before. But today I'm going to show you how to sell crops. Now, so we're going to be bringing it to the windmill, which is 685. So I'm going to be recording a course for the windmill. Now, first of all, I'm going to set up a folder for sales, because I do like having all of my courses in folders. And now I'm going to bring up PDA to see where the windmill is. Where's the windmill? Over here. I'm just trying to plan the course in my mind before I do it. I suppose that way would do it. Bring it across here, down along this road, around this loop, up to the windmill, and then bring it back down. Or would it be better to... I don't know the optimal route, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring it along this road here, which I know is tight. Bring it down along this loop. Actually, this loop up here looks better. It might be a bit tighter, but it looks like it's a shorter route. And I'll just bring it back down along the same way. Okay, so let's get going. So, the first trick, well, the first thing you need to know, is that you can start a course any which way you want, heading in any direction. But if you're doing sales courses, it's best to keep them all going in the same direction. And seeing as the closest sell point to me is the grain elevator, which is here, I'm going to want to start courses heading downwards. So what you do is you line up the trailer, and you may have to re-record this for different trailers, so this isn't a one-size-fits-all course. I'm recording this for the Brantner because that's the trailer I have, and you're just going to start a course recording. It doesn't matter what mode you're tractors in at the very start, you can change it afterwards. Now I'm recording these courses with keyboard. Actually no, I'm going to switch to my controller because this is going to be a permanent course. I don't want to be recording this multiple times. So I'm going to bring the tractor out. First 2 points ideally are put in a straight line. It pretty much stops a lot of problems the Courseplay can have. So I'm going to bring it up around and loop it so that I can get to the road that I want. And the road that I want, I'm getting some lag for some reason, the road that I want is over here. Now the best thing to do is keep all of your tractors on the right hand side. Now the game's lagging today. I think it's because I haven't rebooted my computer for some, I think it might be that reason. The best tactic to use with Courseplay is always to keep courses on the right. Why does this always happen? Whenever I'm recording these tutorials I get problems. Keep the courses on the right because that way you won't have too many collisions. And especially when you're getting an overlap like here, you're going to want one to be on the right and one to be on the left, no matter which way you look at it. So when you're recording, always, 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 always keep the tractor to the right. I'm dealing with lag again. I hope the game doesn't crash, because that tends to happen if I'm lagging this much. Yeah, there we go. You're going to want to keep it up to the right at all times. So, ideally you'll be recording this with a controller or a G27. If you're recording this with a keyboard, really you want to keep kind of tapping on W. Tapping on the power key, or set cruise control to about 30 kilometers an hour. I find that works the best. If you're using a keyboard, you're going to want to set a fairly low cruise control to what you'd be used to, just to make sure things are working out properly. Now with controllers, if you're using a keyboard, I think I said if you're using a controller, keep a low cruise control. If you're using a keyboard, keep a low cruise control. If you're using a controller, you can probably get away without cruise control. Which way am I going? This way. Okay, so I'm going to pull it out onto the road. Pull out. There's more lag as it's trying to load up something, I believe. don't have anything that should be loading up here. Okay, so I'm going to bring around this loop down here. In fact, no, I wanted up the top loop, so I've made a mistake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause it and delete the points that I don't want. If the game lets me. So I'm going to just delete it until it's... Okay, I'm going to have to drive forward through this. When the game lets me. So you can see I've deleted back to that point there, where the stop sign is. That's not a permanent thing. I'm just going to realign myself with the course here. And hit the pause button one more time. And we're going to go the other direction, the direction that I wanted to go in the first place. There we go. That wasn't an intentional error, that was a genuine mistake by me. So you just bring it along here, and when you're driving, when you get these on the road and you've got the course running, I'll show you towards the end, because it is important. You want to set a fairly low cruise control again of about, we want to set the max speed to 30 kilometers an hour. Okay, so I'm going to have to make some sort of... This could be problematic, because this road is too tight for me to record side-by-side courses, so I'm going to have to create a loop. Yeah, I'm definitely going to have to create a loop, because there's no way two Courseplay tractors are going to get across this. Oh, don't tell me I got to go up there. Do I have to go up this incline? Oh my god, I do. So yeah, I'm definitely going to create a loop here, and hopefully a tractor with a full trailer will actually make it up here. This is what, 30%? I think I'm now on the correct road. Yes, I am on the correct road now. Do I have to go to the next road up? Okay, so I didn't know that bridge existed. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna pretty much be improvising from here out. Just to keep on the right side of the road, I'm gonna go this way. This course is too is now too long for its own good. You can see I'm up to 220 points. And the game's decided it wants to load something. There we go. Decided it wants to load something again. There we go. And again. So, this is probably not the best course in the world, but it will suffice for what I want. Really, this is just a demonstration course. So, I'll be re-recording this after I've finished with this. So when you get to the windmill, or wherever your sell point is, where are these points going? They're going under the bridge! That's brilliant! Oh, I didn't know that happened! I knew it happened in Hagenstadt when you were going over bridges in 2013, but I didn't know that was still a thing. I should explain. Courseplay is a bit weird. It likes sticking to the terrain. It almost suicidally so. So if you're going over a bridge, Courseplay will just ignore the fact there's a bridge there and stick the points down on the ground. So that's Courseplay over the fill trigger, or over the trigger. And I'm gonna want to go left here. So we just bring it out slowly. Now we bring it up to full speed. Now again, if you're doing this on keyboard, you're gonna want to keep a reasonable speed so that you can keep full control of the tractor at all times, because I know the keyboard controls, especially in 2015, they're a bit finicky at times and they can pretty much go off on their own little tangents. So I'm gonna want to take this road. Yes, I'm gonna want to take this turn off. And the joy of Courseplay is I can just set If I do something like that, I can set it to ignore what I've actually done while recording the course. You can set it to go the same speed as when you were recording the course. But, what I do is I wait for farm sim to reload. I'm having awful trouble today. It shouldn't be funny, but it is. What I do is I reset Courseplay, and I actually just stop up here and show you. I set Courseplay to, if you see here, street speed is automatic from course and the speed is from recording. You can actually reset it to maximum, to a set maximum speed, so it'll completely ignore what speeds you did on the course while recording, so you can stop up, have a cup of tea while recording if you really, really want to, and just kind of abandon your tractor. And when you wanted to do the course, you're going to just reset the maximum speed to, we'll say, an ideal is about 30 kilometers an hour, because that's roughly the same speed as the traffic vehicles. So I'm going to be taking this turn off up here to the left, because I know for a fact this leads up to the farm, and it's the only bit of the map that I've somewhat memorized because of bail transport. Like I said, this is my Let's Play map, so I'm going to be re-recording these courses until I'm really, really happy with them. The course I'm on now, I'm not happy with at all. So you can see I'm going at 29-30 kilometers an hour, and I'm just sticking with the AI traffic. That's perfectly fine in my books. I don't want to be overtaking it. Game, please load. I hope Expla isn't cutting this out, because that could be problems. I've said some important things in these cutout bits, if they are cut out. Okay, so you see I'm sticking it under I'm going to be cutting these bits out myself, but it looks like. Come on. It's trying to load everything up at the farm, I believe. Okay, so I'm sticking under 30 kilometers an hour. That's intentional. I don't want to be trying to overtake the AI vehicle, because that'll cause the course to go off the road or into the other lane, which I don't want. If I'm in the other lane, there's a very, very real chance that while Courseplay is controlling the tractor, a vehicle will come up in the other lane and crash into it and stop the course. If I'm in the wrong lane, there's a real chance that Courseplay will completely ignore the fact that it's in the wrong lane and just continue on as normal. Now, I've realised Expla isn't cutting these bits out on me, which is kind of nice, so I can just use these bits of lag as extended explanation times. If there's a vehicle in the opposing lane, it's not going to care. It's just going to keep going and try to keep going. So I'm going to bring the tractor back up here now, and again stay on the right hand side. Try not to overlap the courses at all if I can avoid it, because again, Courseplay just follows the course blindly, doesn't try to avoid collisions, unlike a human or a player, unless you know you're doing tractor jousting, in which case go for collisions all you like. So this is going to be a pretty long tutorial by the looks of things. So the real aim is to just stay on the right and try to avoid overlapping the course, because if you do, there will be problems. At any point, if the courses overlap, you're probably going to end up with a tractor. Occasionally they'll even be front corner to front corner, in which case it's a situation. You know, if the courses cross at a right angle or at any kind of angle, I've seen it happen to myself. It's happened to me so many times, where the front corners of the tractors have you know, crossed each other's paths, and Courseplay doesn't know what to do. I mean, it doesn't say, oh, this tractor should stop so that the other one can get past. No, it just says, hey, I'm stuck, and I'm confused, and I'm lost. Help me, please, help. There's no middle ground there. There's no avoidance of collisions. So when you get to the end of the course here, you're going to want to just kind of slow it down a bit and line up again for even getting in cab, which is not the most advisable thing for me when it's lagging like this, but you're going to want to get in cab and choose a central reference point, such as, I'm just going to show you now with the mouse. This is really good in the T4, the sun visor here. You can use that as a central reference point and just line it up with the start trigger, and then once it's on the start trigger, you're done. And you stop the recording, and you just, now I'm not going to set it off on this recording, but you set the street speed to 30 kilometers an hour and you drive the course. Now it does help if the course is grain transport load at start, not combine mode, because then the tractor will automatically load itself up with wheat and stop. You can choose exactly what you want to load in. Now for the likes of wood chips, you'll notice there is, I'm just going to bring you over to the wood chip storage area over here. Potatoes, sugar beet and wood chips. For potatoes and sugar beets, you don't have to use the conveyor belts at the back. They're useful if you want to do it yourself, but I've found Courseplay tends to ignore them. What you can do is you can record a course that stops up in the area in front of the silo, or we'll say a course that stops up over here somewhere, even right here, because that's kind of in the line you want to be going. And you can have a tractor with a front loader or a wheel loader or a telehandler. You can have that pull the potatoes, sugar beets or wood chips right out of these storage units. Dump it in the tractor. The tractor will realize, hey, I'm being loaded by something. I'm going to stay here until it hits. I'm going to re-enter here. Until it hits its drive-on trigger. So in the brander here, I've got it set at 70%. Now, if you really want, you can put it to 100%. If you're a bit loopy, you can set it to 0% and it'll just constantly drive. 70% I use because that's about the level my combine fills the Brantner up to. It sounds a bit odd that I'm using a 70% drive-on trigger for this. You know, for completely emptying a silo. The thing is that when you're on a loaded start course, it will load until it's full. Failing that, it'll wait 5 to 10 seconds, and if it's hit its drive on trigger, it's gonna drive on. So you can, you know, you can set a low drive on trigger. If you really want to get everything out of it, you can set 10%, 0%, and it'll still drive along in here, line itself up, stop at the start trigger, which is kind of unusual, fill itself up as much as it can, and continue onwards. So yeah, this is particularly useful if you've got multiple tractors. Again, it's best with multiple tractors on this kind of course. You're really going to want to, we'll say, have, if I've got three T4s with three Brantners, I'm going to want to wait until this one's full, and while I'm sitting in the second one, which I'll have parked here, we'll say, for example, say, when that's full and it's started to drive, I'll set this tractor to drive in behind it. Because then you don't end up with, well, if you watch my Westbridge Hills series, you'll have seen they were always constantly stuck in traffic because I didn't set them up right, and they were all using different sized trailers. ideally you're going to use three of the same tractor, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 even of the same tractor, with the same amount of trailers. We'll say for an ideal situation for me, I'd maybe have 3 T4s and 3 Brandners. I'd have them all lined up in a row at the start, set the first one off, wait until it's fully loaded, then set the second one off as the first one's pulling away, so that it doesn't get stuck in traffic there. When it gets to the emptying point, it won't be stuck in traffic. So the third one, you know, if you set them up when all on the same trailer, all on the same tractor, there won't be many issues with Courseplay traffic. Now, AI traffic is a different matter, and that's always going to be problematic because, well, apparently the AI traffic is made of cement. So, this has been your Farming Simulator 15 Courseplay tutorial on selling your crops with Courseplay. Now, of course, with potatoes, sugar beet, and wood chips, it's going to be a bit different. You're gonna record the same kind, of course, but in an ideal situation, you're actually going to stop up in front of the silos where you can't automatically get it loaded, and you're going to pretty much be unloading it yourself. Okay, sorry, I got a text on my phone and I just wanted to check it. You're going to be unloading it yourself because it's the easiest thing to do. Courseplay tends to ignore or completely miss the conveyor belts. I found it's a lot easier to just manually load them in that case. So yeah, I've been Rainbow Dave. This has been your Courseplay tutorial on selling your crops. Please comment, like, subscribe and all that nonsense. I will see you next time or in my Let's Play, which you can also find on this channel. Just click on more videos or something. Click on my name and subscribe, and then you'll find all of the things with things. Yes. Thank you for watching and goodbye.